Hi, this is Karen McKee, the scientist videographer, and no, that was not the opening scene of a new horror film, but instead was a demo of some new gear that I'm going to be talking about in this video. I got that strange shot with something called an iStabilizer Dolly and my cell phone. And here you can see how I used it to shoot that sequence of a doll with a pumpkin head. It's almost Halloween, and this doll was a handy prop to use to do this demonstration. So let's take a closer look at this dolly and how it works and how you might use it to create some interesting tracking shots for your science videos.
First off, what is a dolly and how is it used in filmmaking? Well, a dolly is a device used to capture a tracking shot, which is one in which the camera is not stationary, but is being moved smoothly along some pre-planned trajectory. Dollies used by professionals can be quite elaborate and expensive, such as this one in this photo, and are designed to be used with professional movie cameras. The iStabilizer Dolly is designed to get similar tracking shots, but is much more affordable, portable, and flexible, and is designed to hold any smartphone.
Okay, so this is the iStabilizer Dolly, and you can see that it consists of some wheels, which look like roller skate wheels, and these are attached to a flat metal plate. And to that plate is attached an extension pole, which is flexible. And on top of that is attached a mount for your phone or small camera, which is spring-loaded. And so the way this would work is you would slip your phone into that mount like so. And so now you can change the angle of the view any way you wish. You can angle it up to get a shot of the sky, or if you want a shot low to the ground, you can angle it this way. And then you can control the trajectory by changing the angle of the wheels. If they're straight, obviously you're going to get a straight tracking movement. But then if you want a curved trajectory, just angle the wheel slightly and this will create a curved or semicircular movement of the dolly, and that will give you quite a different perspective in your tracking motion.
In addition to a smartphone, the mount will also accept a small camera, or you can purchase a sturdier mount for cameras such as a Hero GoPro. Next, I tried out some different shooting situations and simple ways to move the dolly. First off, the dolly performs well on smooth surfaces such as a tabletop or a floor, and it's easy to attach a string, allowing the dolly to be moved along in a straight line or a curved trajectory. And the stability of the resultant footage depends on how smooth your shooting surface is. There are a number of ways to use this dolly on smooth surfaces. For example, you might want a 360-degree pan of a specimen of some type. Here is a lichen-covered rock, for example. And another one of some pottery. Such shots would work out well in a laboratory setting, shooting on a bench top, a table, or other flat surface. I next tried the dolly out on a slightly rough surface, my patio. You can see that the patio surface has a slight texture to it, but is generally flat. But as you can see, the resultant footage shows every bump and shake. Here's another trial. This time I turned the phone so that the camera was facing forward, and I pushed the dolly along with the meter stick, which is another way to move it over longer distances. Again, the footage is really jumping all over the place. The final trial I did was in one of my flower beds to simulate shooting in a field setting along a forest floor, for example. My flower bed is covered with pine bark chips. It was more difficult to move the dolly, certainly not smoothly. And here's the resultant footage. Not too good. My final analysis is that this dolly will work well on smooth surfaces, is very portable, flexible, and easy to set up and use. It's not going to work very well, however, on rough surfaces or on uneven ground. That is, unless you use a track or a platform to create a smooth surface like they do in making feature films.
And that's about it. I hope you find this tip about the iStabilizer dolly useful. This is Kara McKee, the scientist videographer. Thanks for watching.